1999. Welcome to Live MTV. The Backstreet Boys live today, and what an amazing sight it is here at our Times Square studio. I'm Carson Daly. Welcome to the show. Unbelievable how many people have come out. Outside is incredible. We've got an amazing studio audience here. And we've got the next 2 hours with the Backstreet Boys. All right. Of course, the Backstreet Boys have a new record, Millennium, coming out on Tuesday. We're very excited for that. We're going to chat with the guys. We have a great show coming up. You're sick of hearing my voice and seeing my face. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the Backstreet Boys.
This is insane.
This is crazy.
Backstreet Boys are here. All right.
Hello.
All right, guys. There's a great shot outside.
That's
We're gonna
amazing.
Have plenty of time. Settle down, settle down, settle down. All right. Coming up, we've got 2 hours with the boys. We got two live performances. We're going to take your phone calls from all over the country, 888-311-4343. We even have questions that came from Europe, some of your biggest fans in Europe. We're going to get some questions
cool.
from them.
Cool.
If you want to email, you can email a question. You can visit the Backstreet page, mtv.com. We're going to take a closer look at all of you guys. The people in the studio here have been hand-selected to be here. We're going to have a trivia contest. We're going to have a whole lot of fun. Settle down.
Hey, guys. Guys, hang on a second. We're going to be
Thanks,
here for
Joe.
The next 2 hours, so. No, wait. So we got to be able to hear what Carson's saying, so let's
Thank you, Kev.
You're good man. You're
Settle
good
down.
Man.
This is crazy. How have you guys been,
good,
first
how
of all?
You been,
good,
man. Good.
It's good to have you here.
It's good to be
we
back.
Didn't think, we were kind of worried that we'd been, you know, absent for a while out of the scene. We didn't know if anybody would show up today, but nice surprise.
Thank you, New York.
But what do you say when you look outside and you see this sort of response? I mean, this is outrage. This is an
wow.
MTV record.
Wow.
That's
God.
Wow. It's very, very overwhelming.
Thank you. It's unbelievable. Thank you.
It's great. It's good to have you guys here. We're all excited about the record coming out. We're going to talk about that. It's going to be fun. Next couple of hours with the Backstreet Boys. Get some performances. We're going to chat with you guys. But today really is about your fans. You know, they really are just the greatest group of fans here in the studio. We're going to take some questions from some fans. All right, settle down, guys. Settle down. Let's take our first question. It's from right over here. Just say your name. If everybody could please just be quiet so we can get these questions out, that'd be great.
Oh, hi. My name's Layla.
Hi, Layla.
Hello.
Hi.
Hi, Layla.
Hi, Nick. I just want to say that I love your music, and it's been a huge inspiration in my life, and I just want to thank you so much for that, just starting
thank
with
you.
That.
Thank you.
My question is, what 90s artist or group has influenced you, and who do you admire?
The 90s?
Let's see.
I think
a lot. For me,
it would have to be Boyz II Men.
Group-wise, yeah.
Just because their first album, but then when Boyz II Men 2 came out, it was
Evolution.
Phenomenal. And they had, four number one singles
yeah.
or something like that. And to think of having all that success, and they're a great bunch of guys. We've had an opportunity to meet them. And they're so very down to earth. We've presented them with awards on award shows, and we look at them with like goo-goo eyes thinking, wow, man, what would it be like to do that? And here we are. So I think I think we as a group kind of look up to them because they are in a group and they've had a lot of success, and we would like to emulate that. And it looks like we're on our way to it. We're trying.
Yeah, and they've stayed so humble too. That's a good point to have about Boys to Men as well as you guys. Through all the success and all of this, you're still the same
nice guys.
Five guys that started this whole thing off. Anybody else want to add an influence to your music?
So I was going to say something. Oh, I think besides, I think one of my, even though it's a different type of music, is Nirvana. I think Nirvana was really
awesome.
Definitely one of the 90s groups. I think they were just a big influence on a bunch of people out there.
Definitely. Breaking through like that.
Yeah.
If you play your songs fast enough, you might be able to hear just a little bit.
Yeah, right.
a little bit of Paulie or Dumb on that.
Good playing.
We're going to take one more question for students for right now, and it's from right over here. Just say your name. Say hi to the guys.
Hi, guys.
Hello.
I just want to thank you so much for inspiring me, and I admire you guys so much, and I believe in everything you do for all your fans. My question is, what's the most creative thing you guys have ever done together as a band?
Kev, did you see the pin she's got of you on her blouse?
What's the most creative thing as a group we've done together?
Can you, like, elaborate on that
bit.
Question,
Golf.
Like, whether it be musically or...
When you guys are together, yeah, in your spare time.
Oh, in our spare time. Let's see.
Wow.
We all got together one time and watched the, what was that movie, That Thing You Do?
Yeah.
That was pretty fun.
Tom Hanks movie.
Yeah.
Yeah, it was good.
That was pretty fun. And we were like, wow, it'd be cool to do that someday. So.
We went to, remember, this is going way back, about 4 years ago. We were doing high school, middle school tours. We went to a dude ranch.
Yeah.
That's right.
Yeah. Out in Arizona. We took a wagon ride.
We cooked
steaks.
Wagon ride and had like steaks going out there, and the cowbell
the
was going.
Come and get it.
Yeah.
Serenade the ponies.
All right, we're going to take a quick break. When we get back, more of the Backstreet Boys. It's Backstreet Boys live on MTV today. A live performance from the guys next. You don't want to miss it. Stick around.
We're joined with the Backstreet Boys, who were nice enough to come in this morning. I know you guys did Saturday Night Live last night.
Yeah, we had a great time.
The second time. How was it?
It was
awesome.
Great.
Howie,
guys,
great.
Howie got to do a little acting last night.
Howie made his acting debut, everybody.
Howie!
Did you get your SAG card?
What's that?
You ready for a big time motion picture now?
Yeah, get a SAG card. He's going
to. Armageddon 2.
After.
How was the SNL thing like? Is it all week with the rehearsals and all of that stuff? Is it rigorous, or is it just
It's a lot of fun. The whole cast, this is the second time we've been there, and they're always really just really nice people.
Yeah.
And we went to the little after party last night and hung out with them. So, we can sing these notes for you, okay?
How late were you out last night at the after party? Can we ask?
About 3 o'clock.
About 3 a.m.
Backstreet Boys. Partying last night.
We don't advise you to do that.
It's not good if you gotta sing the next day. Don't do that. You gotta sing good.
Well, we're excited because on Tuesday, Millennium comes out, and I've been very lucky to be hosting Total Request Live, and your first single off the record is just through the roof. Congratulations.
Thank you.
You're gonna perform it for us right now.
Thank you.
Live in our studio, the Backstreet Boys Live. Here they are performing I Want It That Way.
Yeah, yeah. My fire, the one desire, believe when I say that I want it that way.
When we are two worlds apart,
Backstreet Boys.
Thank you.
Very nice, very nice, very nice. Thank you guys very much. We're going to take a quick break. When we get back, your phone calls, your questions. Hell, it's your day with the Backstreet Boys live on MTV. More Backstreet Boys Live next. Is the biggest crowd MTV has ever had. You're looking at a live shot at 1515 Broadway in Times Square.
I don't have any communication.
Look at that overview. That is incredible.
Wow.
Usually on a Sunday afternoon, you can see tumbleweed going down. Not today. The Backstreet Boys live in our studios, our guests, and we couldn't be happier. Welcome back to Backstreet Boys Live. I'm Carson Daly. I'm with the Backstreet Boys now, and I do want to mention that we are on live in Italy. So we're going to say hello to
Hello, Italia.
What's up?
Ciao.
Come stai, huh?
Molto bene. We're here with the guys. Yes, of course. And we're going to talk to Tiffany now. Tiffany has called in. Tiffany, are you there?
Hi, Carson. Hi, Backstreet Boys. I love you guys. I love you, Howie.
Thank you.
See, now you're a big actor.
Howie.
See?
Yeah.
Tiffany, what's your question?
I was wondering, everybody knows that the new CD is called Millennium. Well, are you guys going to be having like a big New Year's concert to celebrate the Millennium?
We haven't really made plans that far in advance yet. We're trying to plan our schedule out so we can. We're planning a big world tour, so we're trying to get around to all the countries on the tour. So we really haven't made plans for that yet. We've been working in the past six New Year's Eves, we've been working. So I don't know. It might be a time for us to maybe just be with our family.
Well, there
friends.
Is no better place to ring in the Millennium than right here. So
if
you want to come in and have
maybe
a
maybe we'll be right here in Times Square. Yeah. You know.
We would love to have you.
Yeah, I wish you guys could celebrate it here in Phoenix, though.
You're calling Phoenix?
Yeah, bad chance, Tiff.
Phoenix, Arizona.
Cool. That's where we did that Dude Ranch ride.
Thank you, Tiffany.
Thank you, Tiffany.
Thank you.
Thanks,
I love you,
Tiffany.
Bye. Some of your biggest fans are in Europe, and we have MTVs all over the world, and we went out to the streets in Europe, and some of your fans there would right now like to ask you some questions. Let's watch cool. The monitor right now.
Excellent.
Hi, my name is Alex. I came from Naples, Italy, and I wanted to ask you guys, how do you feel you've changed since the beginning as an artist and human beings?
Wow. I don't think we really changed as human beings. I mean, I can pretty much speak on behalf of the guys. I mean, I think we're very, you know, very well grounded. You know, our feet are still on the ground, even though we've been very fortunate to have a lot of success. Especially Nick, he wears those heavy shoes.
Yeah.
So
as Nick just demonstrated.
But I mean, I guess it's because you know we've come from. we've come from, I guess, really good families, and all of our families, and along with each other, we all keep each other in check and in line.
That's got to help too.
Definitely. But I'd say
thing.
Time-wise,
oh, yeah, we don't let each other's
changed.
Heads get too swollen. We knock each other down pretty good.
I know we've grown as artists, you know, because this is our craft, being an artist and being a singer, songwriter, whatever. And we've had experiences that we'll take with us, you know, for the rest of our lives. Because when you spend 100% of your time doing this, you know, if you're not getting better,
you're getting worse.
Right.
So
exactly.
We're trying to
so
get
we're
better.
Trying to just always. Not necessarily outdo ourselves, but just keep up with ourselves.
And continue to grow, which you're definitely doing. We're going to take a look at another question coming from Europe. Watch your monitor there.
Hi, I'm Sally from Leamington Spa. I think you're really funky dancers, and I want to know, who's your choreographer? Do you do all your moves yourselves? Because they're so good.
What the hell did she say?
Bloody hell.
Who's our choreographer?
Speak English!
I think you're a really funky dancer.
That's who's your choreographer? You're all right. Who's he? It's all right.
Don't
right.
Take the Mickey, Brian.
I can understand the rest of it.
Shh,
I like that thing you do in the video.
It's beautiful. I love it so much. It's smashing.
So how much time
smashing.
Do you got?
Yeah, baby, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Actually, we feel like our forte is our singing more so than our dancing. But we have a great choreographer who's been working with us for a while, Fatima Robinson.
Oh,
she's,
Laura, huh?
she's, been,
she does. She works with everybody. She started out, I think her big break was when she did Michael Jackson's Remember the Times video.
Yeah.
And she helps us. She helps us do our thing, and she's helped us grow as performers and as dancers as well.
So. She just did the Will Smith's Wild Wild West.
Wow, that's a hell of a video.
That. Yeah.
So a lot of those dancers that are in the video are coming out on tour with us. They're in a lot of our videos
also.
It'll
be a great tour.
Awesome. For everybody at home, I mean, I can attest to this. The last couple of weeks of hosting TRL, the mail I've gotten, I've received every piece of bribery. They're available to be sitting right here, right now, live with the Backstreet Boys. And I do want to acknowledge how many wonderful people wrote amazing letters and parents trying to hook up their kids and everything, and I thank you for that, and so I'm sure do they.
Thank you.
To get into this room, though, believe me, it took something special. All of these people sent in videotapes, and literally hundreds of people actually came down to our studios and had to literally go through a Backstreet Boys quiz, a test. It's tough work to be in here today, and if you don't believe me, just take a look at this.
It's not just the melodies that they could do. I was just like, I want to be that. I want to be a Backstreet Boy. Is that so much to ask?
AJ, you inspired me. Look. Please let us be on your Backstreet Boy special.
Backstreet Boy, it's...
Pick me, Backstreet Boys, because I love you.
What up, everybody? We are the boys. Put your hands together and make some noise.
So I can stop living this fantasy with her because she's annoying me now.
We're gonna go see my mom, who really doesn't want to be on camera, but she has to tell you what she always says, and I swear to God she says this. Mommy, what do you always say?
Nick's got the cutest butt and the Backstreet Boys and the mom.
But Kevin, I love you, and my daughter wants you to marry her mom.
I know everything about the Backstreet Boys. I know that Nick's feet smell as bad as the cheese on his pizza. I know that Kevin sleeps naked. I know that Howie's favorite color is purple, and he loves purple on women.
Which Backstreet Boy is a licensed scuba diver?
Nick Carter.
What's Kevin's middle name?
Scott.
Okay, who's the biggest flirt?
Biggest AJ!
What type of food does Howie like?
Chinese.
Who's afraid of heights?
Brian.
What's Kevin's fast name?
Quincy.
Who's afraid of heights?
Brian.
Where was Kevin?
The Backstreet fans, some of which
that was really
are here
good.
Today. Great job, guys.
Awesome. What are your comments and thoughts as you watch something like that?
That's
overwhelming.
Man. That is unbelievable.
They really do know flattering. Everything. I mean, they really do. It's sort of frightening.
I like Nick's butt.
Who doesn't?
What do you know?
I do want to acknowledge... Hang on one second. We'll get to Nick's butt in a minute.
No, we won't.
I want to acknowledge Kim Perkuski. Kim, where are you? Did I get your name right there?
Perkuski,
excuse me. You traveled the furthest of anybody in the room, I believe. Where did you come from, and tell us about your trip?
Monroe, Wisconsin. It was about 1,000 miles or so.
And you drove?
Yeah.
When did you leave?
We left Saturday night about 10 o'clock.
And you just drove straight through?
Yeah, my dad did.
Wow.
Well, it take you about 12 hours?
Thank about 16.
16 hours?
Yeah. What were your thoughts on the drive here? What were your thoughts, Kim, on the drive here, knowing that today was going to happen for you?
I was still in shock. I am so excited. I'm, like, so happy to be here.
Well, you came a long way, and you certainly deserve to ask the guys a question, so.
Well, thank you for coming all that way.
Thank you.
And thanks to your dad for driving.
Yeah, he was out there somewhere.
I bet he was like this.
Those Backstreet Boys.
How would you compare Millennium to Backstreet Boys?
I think it's definitely a growth for us.
It's a big growth for us. I mean, compared to the first album,
it's a new one.
I mean, vocally, it was a lot more challenging. A lot of the words, lyrically, is a whole lot deeper. And it just means a whole lot. It's a lot more personal to us because a couple of the songs were written by some of us. Kevin wrote a song, Back to Your Heart. Brian wrote The Perfect Fan. So it's like, it's just a more personal album. And on top of that, the album is also dedicated to Dennis Pop, who was one of our producers who passed away last year. So it's definitely something deep for us.
And you know what we're going to do? We're going to take a break. When we get back, we're going to continue to talk about the album that everybody's going to rush out and get Monday night at midnight. More with the Backstreet Boys live on MTV with the biggest crowd we've ever had in our Times Square studio. We'll talk about Millennium with the guys next. Stick around. Live on MTV, Carson Daly, joined by the Backstreet Boys, and so many devoted fans outside literally spent the night, stayed out there all night long, all this morning, just to even catch a glimpse, and our specially selected studio audience that jumped through hoops to be here as well. We couldn't be happier to have the guys here. Tuesday, the Backstreet Boys sophomore album, Millennium, hits stores, and we are excited to talk about this record. My question is, after the success of the first one, you know, this 28 million worldwide, what are your priorities when you sort of regroup and go, you know, we're going to make another record together as a band? What are you, and you take all the stuff that you've grown and then maybe the music that you've heard since you were last in the studio. What's your priority list for Millennium?
Just to definitely make this album a growth for us. We're always constantly, you know, setting new goals, and we want every album just to top the last album. And it's very hard. I mean, the success that we had off the last album, I mean, thank God we were very fortunate to have, like you said, 28 million across the whole world. And like I said, we just tried to, you know, make it the best that we can. We got together with some great producers, some of the same producers from the last album. There's some stuff that's on this album from us. So I think we feel that this is our strongest album ever. And we hope that everybody else feels that way once they hear it.
I'm sure they will.
Kevin, you and Brian both wrote on the record. You want to tell us about your song? I mean, the record's not out yet. No one really has it, but...
Of course, you guys do. We all decided that, I mean, we've been wanting to make the transition into more of writers for our own material. That's a growth process. We didn't want to rush into it. I mean, a lot of artists have started out not writing all their songs like Janet and Michael and Madonna. They grew into it, and that's something that we want to do. And I decided that I would like to work with Grammy Award-winning songwriter Gary Baker, who wrote I Swear a couple years back. Mm-hmm. And I went and spent the week at his home in Alabama and sat down on his piano and started playing a song that I'd been working on. He got his guitar, and 2 hours later, we had Back to Your Heart.
Very good.
So that's how it came out. So,
AJ, tell us a little bit about, is there anything that you guys hear musically, what's going on? You know, like Nick mentioned Nirvana as being something that he was into. In the last 3 years, as you know, listen to the radio or whatever, that may have influenced some stuff on this record?
Wow. I mean, there's been a lot of new groups and new kinds of sound. The whole punk scene is really making a real strong thing, like Korn and Orgy and Limp Bizkit and all that kind of stuff is really happening now, and it's... Like, we were trying to get a little bit edgier on this album, like songs like Larger Than Life, having that rock guitar in there, and songs like Don't Want You Back with that kind of real edgy hip-hop type feel. So we're just trying to kind of get edgier, but not, we don't want to make a 360 and totally do something that's not Backstreet Boys.
Right.
We don't want to do something that's not us. So, but I mean, there's still some similarities compared to the first album, but this is definitely, I think, and I think I can speak on behalf of the rest of the guys, this album kicks Backstreet Boys in the butt. So I think this one's definitely going. Right.
I'll take your word for it. I agree. Nick, what do you think? You agree? Of course you do. It's your record. We're going to see your butt here eventually, I promise you.
Show the world, man. Show the world.
You don't want
I don't
to.
Know about that. Hey, speaking of
We're going to take a look at... All right, guys. We're going to take a look at this commercial campaign that you guys put together for Millennium.
Oh. This is fun.
Oh, boy.
Just, if you're at home, just watch your TVs right now.
The countdown is on!
On. Surf's up and the countdown is on.
Countdown is on!
Backstreet Boys, Millennium, the new album, May 18th.
Awesome. Not that you needed a genius commercial to help you sell the record, but that's very funny.
That was fun.
Where'd that stuff come from, guys?
That was our acting debut.
We were just trying to do something right fun and stupid.
And that was funny. We were trying to bring, you know, we're looking at Millennium, or the album itself, as this is the first album we've ever released worldwide at the same time. The first singles and everything planned properly. So we wanted to tie in, like, all regions of the world, like, you know, Egypt or, you know, Spain or Europe.
The
or
jungle.
Just all kinds of
We don't know where Nick's where don't know where they're from.
Right. Well, we've also not only enjoyed the Backstreet Boys' music, but certainly their music videos here at MTV. And when we get back, we're going to take a look back at the music videos from the Backstreet Boys. More of the Backstreet Boys live right here on MTV next. Stick around. Backstreet Boys live on MTV. Excited fans outside and just an awesome, awesome group of people joining us. We're all very excited about Backstreet Boys releasing Millennium on Tuesday. They were nice enough to come in today for a couple of hours, and still coming up, we have another live performance from you guys. More questions from you here in the audience, from you guys at home, your emails, and more questions from Europe as well. We got the whole planet covered, I think it's safe to say. We want to talk a little bit about now. You guys have obviously one album out, one album about to come out, and seven music videos. How do you enjoy the music video process, making the videos?
I think it's really cool. It's a chance for us to actually do a little bit of acting in our videos, which you can see where we all try to ham it up big time. But it's fun.
It's fun.
It's a long day. It's a very long day. Some of our videos have been actually a couple days. And
it's fun to come up with treatments ourselves and come up with ideas and meet with directors, like the whole way Backstreet Back came to be. You know, that was just an idea of the five of us talking on the way over to Europe one time on the plane, and we talked about it with Joseph Kahn, and it ended up winning us an MTV Music Award. So
awesome. Congratulations. Well, we're going to go back. How far are you going back?
Way back in the time.
First video the Backstreet Boys did in 1995. Got it going on. Let's take a look at these. Nick, come on in here. I hope you guys can see all right.
Wow.
Your first video. What are you thinking at this point? Tell us about it.
We're trying not to mess up the dance steps right now.
We've definitely grown up a little bit.
This, the leather outfits that we were shown in the park, that was the hottest day of the year.
It was the hottest day of the year ever.
We were wearing leather and jean jackets and stuff like that, so we were sweating like pigs.
If you notice in this video too, AJ doesn't have any facial hair. No facial hair and no tattoos.
Look at him.
No tattoos.
I was a good boy back then.
We look like little big kids.
This video, the singing shot in this recording studio, that's where we recorded our first album. in that recording studio. That's all in Orlando. That's at Sandlando where we play basketball.
Nick's basketball game has come a long way.
A long way. I could.
Basketball a running theme.
I couldn't make a shot in that video at all. So they had like superimpose it.
Yeah.
They had to use editing tricks.
The little cutaway of the ball swish.
Right, right.
Let's take a look at the next video you guys dropped in January of 97. Quit playing games with my heart.
Yeah, this is the one that, we still haven't lived down for the beefcakeness. We got called the beefcakes.
The beefcakeness.
We all decided to do major Caesar hairdos that year, as you can tell.
That's some European influence on it.
This was actually the first video that MTV played of us.
Yeah, this was the big video that we played a lot. Real breakthrough.
If you all notice, we're moving in slow motion, right? Now, check this out. Our mouths are linking up with the video, with the words, but our body's in slow motion. What we did was you run the tape double time, so we're actually singing, "Impossible is amazing, come on, look at it."
When you play it back, you got slow motion.
You play it back, and it's like,
that was actually shot at Howard Middle School, which is back in my hometown.
This is one of the only videos that really doesn't have a concept behind it. It's just sort of you guys lounging,
us
singing.
Us in the rain. Yeah. That was the concept.
Us in the rain on a basketball court.
And then it starts raining.
Just chill out.
Backstreet Boys
Kev,
getting
what's going
on
with the dude there, my
that,
man?
That was
my Oasis.
That was my Oasis phase.
Here's your Oasis phase. I was getting close to my Indian roots when
that's
I was what, in
that's
video.
When we first gave AJ the name Bone.
Look at Nick.
Wow.
All right, let's move on to August of 97, As Long As You Love Me. Was the video...
You're on the phone.
I'm on the phone as usual.
It's reality.
And where'd you guys get the idea for this whole like auditioning thing? Is this sort of a takeoff of something that you guys had to go through, or?
It was Nigel Dick directed this video. It was basically his concept, and then we all met together and made all the decisions about. Like he thought it'd be cool if we were on the opposite side, like we were trying to like the girls were auditioning us for a role or something, you know, like just putting us on the opposite side.
Where did you get these girls from? Are these friends or?
They're just actresses.
What, not from LA?
One of them was
one of the girls
is
in the new Jordan Knight video.
One of those.
Oh, right, in the hot dog stand or?
Yeah, the hot dog stand. Yeah. She's in.
This is the one we actually decided to experiment with hairdos.
Oh,
and,
yeah.
I'll never forget the guys asking me to put me in my hair in an afro. I'll never live it down.
So is there, like, a makeup guy, like, on the set who's like, Howie, we're going to hook you up with, like, a...
He put me in the biggest afro mondo I've never had in my life.
Hey, you know what? You could do a bigger one now.
Look at Brian's got it. Brian's... Now it'd be too big.
The next video was huge.
Whoa,
it was a monster production. One of a kind. Everybody. Backstreet's back. Now this right here for the Backstreet Boys, I mean, this was really just a whole new level right here, this video.
Yeah, we wanted to come with a 90s version of a Thriller.
Yeah, was this based on, like, you know, the Thriller thing? And that was such a huge video when you saw Thriller on MTV. It was just like, wow, this is more than a video.
I mean, it was, but the concept was a little different, I guess you could say, because there was five different characters.
Right.
Hey, speaking of Thriller and the Jacksons, I know today is Janet Jackson's birthday, so we want to say happy birthday out to Janet Jackson out there. So
big
birthday, big fans of.
Oh, that's sweet of you, Howard.
That's what they call me,
sweetie. Nice of you.
You been talking to Janet?
We're gonna take a look at some of your different looks from the Everybody video and see what's going on. Brian, sort of a werewolf.
It's you. He just didn't brush his teeth.
I've been to the dentist since then. So.
It's you in the morning on the bus.
Had a root canal.
He's a yuck mouth. AJ, you're next. Like a Phantom of the Opera.
AJ was having a little skin problem.
I was having real bad skin.
He had to be one of the
back then. Wasn't using my Stridex properly.
Kevin, you're next.
You too.
I didn't really understand you, Kevin, in this video. What exactly was that there?
Well, it's like Jekyll and Hyde.
Okay.
But we didn't want to go with the old lame movie one, so we went with like a reptilian look, like the scales from a reptile from a...
It's got a bit of acne on it.
Howie, you're next in the Everybody video.
Howie, nice shot, dog.
Woo! He had his teeth filed down since then.
Yeah.
I wanted to be Dracula initially, but.
And bring on Mummy
bring
Nick.
Bring on the Mummy.
There you go. That's scary looking right there.
All right, let's move on. Next came on Never Break Your Heart. This one debuted on Total Request Live on September 14th, 1998. It hit number one 18 times.
I hate my hair in this video, Carson.
AJ hates his hair in this video.
I hate my hair in this video.
AJ, AJ looks like
a skunk.
Is it because you look
like
back
a skunk.
On it?
The dude ran out of bleach, so he only got halfway down my head. He couldn't finish my whole head. I wanted the whole thing blonde.
Should have busted out a hat.
It's okay.
Did you guys get a chance to sort of design each of your looks to sort of your rooms?
Yeah, we came up with the concept for what type of rooms we wanted off of our personalities and stuff. Nick, in his room, there's a Japanimation of each one of us on the wall. I don't know if you ever
realized that, but it's like a cartoon, since he's really big into cartoons.
Japanimation of each one of us is like superheroes and stuff like that. This video was one of the easiest ones that we have done.
This is better than the original I'll Never Break Your Heart.
Actually,
when we shot in the snow.
Right.
This was a
we
lot
shot
better.
This video in two different versions. So
Spanish
like
and English.
Spanish and English,
right.
Because we have two different versions. And so we thought we were done with the video. And then they came up, our record company executives came up and they said, well, no, you got to do a Spanish version. So then we stayed here for another 2 hours and did it. But it turned
out
really
good. Every other take was like, I'll never. And then it was like, nunca quiero.
Let's move on. The next one debuted on Total Request Live November 11th, 1998. It hit number one spot 33 different times. All I Have to Give was the song and video.
This is my favorite song.
I think I've seen this video more than anybody on the planet. This video has a lot of style in this video with what you're wearing.
Right. This is my favorite video, too.
Is this Nick's favorite video?
We shot this video actually before I'll Never Break Your Heart.
Yeah,
and they
you can
were
sort
released
tell.
In the you can
we shot tell. Yeah, Backstreet's Back, As Long As You Love Me, and All I Have to Give all within like the same week.
Same week.
Wow.
So we shot this about two weeks between I'll Never and this video. You can tell that it's like this is like a step back in time almost.
Yeah,
my ponytail gets shorter all of a sudden after.
Man, we shot a lot of videos.
Yeah, you have shot.
I didn't realize how many.
Oh, there's one more. Your latest video, the first single off Millennium, I Want It That Way. It's been on Total Request Live for a little over a week.
A little over a week it's been on. It's already been number one 4 times.
Thank you.
I just have one question. Whose fat jet is that? Is that y'all's?
It's not ours.
No.
We got to straighten this up. Everybody's been saying we got a jet. We don't have a jet, okay? It's just it was a prop, basically. It's a large prop, basically.
It's owned by a casino in Reno. Reno, Nevada casino owns it.
A cool element to this video. It almost reminds me of your fans. You use those are real fans in this video.
Definitely. Yeah.
Anybody get out of control while shooting the video?
They're pretty good.
They're really good.
We had a great time. We stayed out. I mean, we shot that video until like 4 in the morning, all in one day. We started at like 8 a.m. and finished at 4 a.m. out at LAX. So.
Well, it'll be on Total Request Live. I'm sure tomorrow you can catch
We're
it.
In airports. We're in airports a lot, so we thought
that was probably like home for
you guys. It was a nice dedication to all the airports you've been in. So.
Right. We're going to take another break when we get back. We know that everybody here in the audience knows a lot about the Backstreet Boys, but how much do they know about each other? We'll put that to the test. Another live performance still coming up. More Backstreet Boys live on MTV. And the largest crowd we've ever seen in the history of MTV. More in a moment. Stay around. Welcome back. You're looking at a live shot of the record-breaking crowd outside our MTV studios for Backstreet Boys Live. Howie, Kevin, Brian, AJ, and Nick are here. The album comes out Tuesday. I'm Carson. Hi, how are you? Nice to have you here, everybody.
It's great to have you here, Carson.
Hi. Thank you.
Good to have you with us, man.
Hello, me. Hi, how are you? Good to see you. Amanda's on the phone from Colorado. Amanda, are you there?
Yeah, I'm here.
Hi, how are you?
Hi, Carson. Hi, Backstreet Boys. I love you, AJ.
Hello. Thank you.
What's your question, Amanda?
Okay, you guys have had a lot of success with your album, but is there anything else
other than singing you would like to pursue, either musically or otherwise?
I think I might mind doing a little bit of acting.
Yeah, after last night.
Maybe a little bit of that.
On Saturday Night Live, Howie made his network debut.
I think no matter what, all of us will be doing something in music for the rest of our lives. You know, if we want to settle down, stop touring, and just live on a farm somewhere and write songs or something. So, I don't know.
On a farm? One of the things I want to do, one of the things I want to do is I want to go to college and play basketball. Big ones to go to the NBA. It's been a dream of mine, and I'm probably, like, when we ever take some downtime, that's probably what I'll do.
But I'm going to go back to school and get a teaching degree, and I'm going to coach Nick on that.
No. He's going to play with me. Yeah. He's going to play with me.
On the same team? One-on-one against each other?
I'm an old man. No, with each other.
We have a question right up here in our audience. Hi, what's your name?
Hi, my name's Rachel. I'm from Fairland, New Jersey. Me and my best friend, Holly, are so happy to be here. And I just wanted to know who thought of the name Millennium and if you were going to call it something else. And can we both have our things autographed, please? Please.
Yeah, we'll take care of you, no problem.
Thank you.
I love you, Brian.
I love you, Nick.
We'll take care of the autographs later. But was there ever another name other than Millennium?
We were, like, throwing up all kinds of names trying to find something that really caught our eye. And we really liked the title Larger Than Life because the song is dedicated to all of our fans. But we thought, you know, Backstreet Boys, Larger Than Life, that would just be totally taken the wrong way. Because, you know, Backstreet Boys, Larger Than Life.
Okay,
No. So we figured what better way for us to come into the new millennium with Backstreet Boys, Millennium. It just fit. It was just right.
Also,
even though everything right now is millennium, it still fit.
Millennium's like a new birth, you know, of another century. And for us, it's like this album here, we feel like it's a new birth with us. I mean, we've had a lot of stuff going on with this last year, you know, a lot of personal issues, business issues, a lot of, you know, family issues, deaths within family, heart surgery. And so this here, we feel like we've grown the strongest this last year. So we're, you know, coming back out, coming stronger. And it's almost like, you know, a rebirth of us again.
And you did already mention that Millennium was going to be released for the first time here in the States and overseas at the same time.
Yeah.
Right. We're going to take another.
It's going to help us a lot as far as our schedules. It's going to, thank God, it's going to help us.
Yeah. Well, we're going to take a question right now from some of your fans. They're singing outside. If we could watch this is a question coming from a fan of yours in Europe. Take a look.
Hi, my name's Monica, and I'm from Luton. Having toured all over the world, which was your favorite country and why?
Remember, you're on American soil now.
Right?
Well, there's no place like home, that's for sure. But I think outside of America, I'd probably say my favorite country was Spain. A little bit of my Latin roots.
Yeah. Kevin, how about you?
I'm loving Italy.
Italy? Somehow I knew you were going to say that. I don't know how. Bri?
I like Australia. It just takes too long to fly there.
Yeah, it's a long trip.
But it's pretty cool because they do speak English and they have 7-Elevens and stuff.
Down under.
All right. All the comforts of home. AJ, how about you?
New York.
Good answer.
That's not a country.
That ain't right, AJ.
I sucked in geography class.
We're sending you back to geography again.
Probably the UK. London was really cool. It's just, you know, it's kind of dismal
town.
All the time. It's always raining, just like Florida. But it's just got a really cool vibe about it. I like it a lot.
Nick, how about you?
I liked Australia and Spain too, because it was the closest part to the ocean. Closest countries to the ocean, which I love the ocean. So.
Right. When you guys go out on the road, what's the sleeping arrangements? Everybody just gets their own big fat suite, or how does that work?
We definitely have our own beds now.
We used to double up back in the day, about 6 years ago. We'd be doubled up in the Motel 6.
With two beds, though. Two beds. It was two beds.
Now we've got, you know, now we can afford our own room.
Yeah, and you travel and stuff.
You say double up, and I don't know.
But I mean, we try to stay budget conscious. We don't stay in the finest suites all over the world.
The bottom line is that you spend so much time together. A couple weeks ago, we were down in Florida. You all were nice enough to fill out some individual questionnaires. So we have those answers, and I thought it'd be a good idea now to see exactly how much you do know about each other.
Uh-oh.
So you'll understand how this works.
Oh, boy.
Let's start, Brian, with you.
Who are you
okay.
asking me about?
Brian, I'm asking you. If AJ could sing a duet with anyone, who did he say it would be?
Who did he say?
On his questionnaire.
He never really
Don't shout it out if you know it, too.
AJ's so fickle, though. It's just like, what day was it?
Right? What day was
I
it?
I don't know.
It?
I can't
and,
say.
And whose song was number one at the time?
He talks about R. Kelly a lot. He talks about...
It's a female.
It's a female?
One okay. word. No.
Aaliyah?
Aaliyah.
No. You said Jewel.
Jewel.
Jewel? Jewel.
Is that right?
I said Jewel. When I saw her on here with you...
AJ, much better. That was good.
When I saw her on TRL
AJ,
with you, good. I was like
I said, what
they were showing the video, and I said, that would be kind of cool.
Yeah. Hey, man.
Just because, you know, it's like everybody's doing duets with all the R&B acts. No one's doing anything with somebody... I mean, they've done Celine Dion, they've done all this kind of stuff. And
that's that Royale answer.
I like, yeah, that was my Royale with cheese for the day.
Cool. All right, Nick, let's go to you. Has Kevin ever gone skinny dipping?
Well, I hope you wouldn't know, it's Nick. A yes or no question.
All right,
so.
50-50.
Easy,
I hope you
man.
Wouldn't know.
Come on,
man. I don't want to know, but
I hope you don't know.
Oh, come on, you
for
know.
For your own sake,
come
you
on,
don't
man,
know.
I think it's yes. I think it's yes.
That's right.
You have?
Kevin, you care to share the story with us?
My dad used to run a summer camp, and it had a big swimming pool. And
man, you sick little monkey.
Me and some friends
man.
Went skinny dipping one time.
All natural, very nice. All right, Howie. When was Nick born, Howie? What's his birthday? Don't shout
Second,
it out.
81, right? Or 80.
Oh. 80. Somewhere around there, right?
D, man, January
It's okay, don't feel bad, Howie. Hey, everybody, when was Nick born? That's right, January 28th, 1980. There you go. Year.
Don't feel bad, Howie. He doesn't know any of our birthdays either, so don't worry
and
about it.
What year was I born?
I guess
you
don't
know. See, you don't even know what year I was born in.
I guess the gifts haven't been coming too well. AJ,
the multiplication. And
what's Howie's favorite movie? What did he say? Tell us his favorite movie was.
Oh. Your favorite movie?
Good, a hard one.
I know the ones you've been in, but I can't remember your favorite movie. Don't give me any hints. I don't want to know.
Popcorn shrimp.
You want a hint?
I can't.
What is don't it? Don't say that.
Does anybody in the audience want to help AJ out?
Somebody. Oh, yeah, right. It just hit me. Willy Wonka and the Chocolate Factory.
Is that right? No, he's saying no.
What is it, D?
The Outsiders.
The Outsiders is the right answer.
Yeah, yeah. You told me the wrong one. Oh, jeez.
That's my favorite book.
AJ didn't get my buzzer.
I'm losing
my
favorite book. Money here.
It's okay.
What happened?
I didn't give it. They did. You know.
Kevin, what's Brian's most embarrassing moment on stage? What did he tell us his most embarrassing moment on stage was? Kevin?
Well, there's been so many. It's something. I'm just kidding.
Let's go back, way back.
Think about it.
Did you sling your microphone out in the audience one?
You forgot the words to a song, right?
Tell him, Brian.
I know it.
You forgot the words to a song.
It was when AJ had to sing my part, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. When
oh,
when
yeah.
I got sick during Boys Will Be Boys.
Yeah, he got sick.
He got sick on stage.
He had a,
little stomach gas reaction
yeah,
sometimes.
Yeah, reflux going on.
Yeah.
Well, it was nerves. I was nervous, and I went to sing my part, and I couldn't sing, and I started coughing, and I turned to AJ, and I was like, AJ, sing
And I
my
didn't
part.
Know the right words, so I was just okay.
Now we got
okay,
some tongues cool. on the side of the stage.
I got you back, bro.
All right.
We want more, man. Come
I know,
on.
I got one more. I'm trying to pick a good one. Brian, what's Nick's favorite video game? What did he tell us?
That's impossible. Well, no, Rock should know that.
I think I know.
No, let's change this then, though.
No, let me see. You got two of them, right?
Is that right?
Two down, right?
Okay, favorite video game.
I know.
He'll never get it?
I bet I know.
Use the mic.
It's from the first Nintendo. The first Nintendo.
From the first Nintendo?
Not Super Nintendo, the first one.
You mean the old one?
Very old.
You
one.
Mean
yeah, two of them.
We
right?
just got a sponsorship,
two.
By the way.
All right, you don't know it.
No, I don't.
Dragon Warrior and
Nick. No, Nick no. something. No, right? Kid Nicky.
Kid Nicky.
It's called Kid Nicky. You guys don't know that. It was really old.
Hey,
you know,
did
I know why.
Know that answer?
Okay. No. I knew why. You know why? Because I was there when you were filling out the papers, and I kind of overheard you say that.
Yeah.
Not
you
bad.
Cheating, Lil.
You should have had it then.
All right, we're going to, not bad. I just read here that if Kevin could be any superhero, he'd want to be Spider-Man. We're going to take a break. Welcome to the live performance from the Backstreet Boys who are here. MTV's Backstreet Boys live. Much more of your questions and that special performance. More telephone calls, more trivia, more with the Backstreet Boys next. Last time I can even think of something that came close. People slept here last night. There's our specially selected studio audience that joins us. I'm Carson. The Backstreet Boys are around me to my right and to my left. We have a call from Ohio now for a question. Hello?
Hey, Carson. Hey, guys. Nick, I love you.
Hi.
My question is that I want to know what you guys think of the whole boy band phenomenon. I mean, you guys are basically the ones to start it out, you know, like, and I just want to know your thoughts on it.
Well,
everybody points at Kev.
It's, you know, when we first came out, we were compared and looked at as the new, you know, whatever that came before us.
Right.
The people that came before us were looked at as the people that came before them. But we look at this as a great opportunity because we've opened a lot of doors for a lot of groups. But we as a group, we try to stay focused on what, you know, we're doing. I think we try to stay focused and well-rounded towards the music rather than getting caught up in trying to follow what everybody else is doing, being that we were first. So it's important to us. You know, we're fortunate that they came, that there's a lot of groups that came behind us. And it's flattering to see that happen because we've kind of set trends musically and in the market, so to say, the pop market, we kind of brought it back. So
was there ever a time where you read something that would, you know, hurt your feelings?
Definitely.
All the time.
I mean,
or do you have to just
when you're in the public eye? When you're in the public eye, I mean, that's just part of it. That's something that you got to get used to. Not everybody's going to like you.
Right.
And there's a lot of people that are going to, you know, crack jokes and stuff. But that's just part of it. You know, you shrug it off and you just got to be
and
happy
like
with what you're doing.
What AJ was saying about the Rolling Stone article that's out right now is just brutally true.
It's just, it was a really good article about everybody because it was just honest. And that's what we want everyone to know is that we're real. We're 100% real. I mean, it's just that was... Honestly, in my opinion, that was the best article I've ever read about all of us. I mean, it broke down every single one of us individually and as a group, and it was just a very honest and truthful, from the heart type of article. It wasn't something that was just made up.
Right. You know, and if that's Quartz is out now, you guys can pick that up. We're going to read an email now that we got during the show. It's from Claire in Trinidad and Tobago, somewhere far away. Tobago. I'm over it. If you guys weren't in the band, where do you think you would be, or what do you think you would be doing, and why, if you weren't here today in this band? So let's go ahead and start with you, Howie.
I think I'd be involved in the entertainment business somehow or another, whether it was still doing singing as a solo artist or doing maybe acting in movies or television somehow or another. That's how, like I say, we met, was, you know, AJ and I and Nick, you know, being in the business when we were younger in Orlando. You know, doing stuff at Universal Studios for Nickelodeon and, you know, appearing in little movies here and there. So, like I said, entertainment's been, you know, a big part of my life since the age of 6 on up. So I think I can't see my life without, you know, being somehow involved in the entertainment field. Also, even producing. I'm actually getting a little bit into the writing and producing. I'm writing and collaborating with a lot of other artists. I collaborated recently with Foxy Brown. I've collaborated with a lot of other artists from people from a Babyface's camp.
Would anybody have not been in the business in any way, shape, or form? Like you mentioned, teaching, or was that ever a possibility if you weren't here?
I would have probably just getting ready to finish up a college, probably at 24, or just finished. And I might have been, you know, studied to be a youth minister at a church, or maybe a teacher, like I was saying.
Very cool.
You know, still singing at church or singing for free.
Nice. I remember the 1997 MTV Video Music Awards, watching Ben Stiller did a sort of a parody. You guys were nice enough to. Oh, it was 98.
That was fun. That
right,
was
whatever
fun.
It was. But you're, we all remember it, I'm sure. Let's watch that actually right now.
Backstreet Boys.
You're the one for me. You're my ecstasy. You're the one I need.
No, there were six Backstreet Boys originally. I was the sixth. No, I was the first Backstreet Boy. It's not that I got kicked out exactly. It's more like I like to think that I threw them out of my band, but they retained the name. Yeah, I basically established Backstreet Boys in 93 when I was a senior in high school, but I was split at the time between my commitment to the band, which wasn't really happening at the time, and then my commitment over at Wet n' Wild Stunt Spectacular at Universal Studios, in which I portrayed the Merman. And at the time, it was a choice, you know, Backstreet Merman.
The truth is, we all got together and said, this train guy's got to go.
Yeah, out in the snow. What do you know, bro?
He's a double zero.
Adios.
Out the dizzo.
He's wacky, yo.
They couldn't deal with his dancing, all right? That much creativity, the mind cannot, it literally shuts down.
His dancing sucked, and he totally threw everybody off.
I don't call what I do dancing anyway. I call it sparkling, all right? That's what I've always done. It's called sparkling. If you do it in a group of other people, it's like if four of us were sitting around talking French, and then another guy starts talking Chinese, you're looking at that guy and go, what's wrong with that guy? You know, oh, he's talking Chinese, okay? Let me tell you something. You don't put leg shackles on Mercury, you don't tell Trent McJivers not to sparkle, and you don't spit on Superman's cape, right? Done. Goodbye. Good night. Baby goes to sleep now.
That's classic, man.
There you go. From the 1998 MTV Video Music Awards. And you guys were good sports about it. That was fun, it looked like.
That was
like
a lot of fun.
He's a really cool guy. We met him after the awards show. And I exchanged numbers with him and actually keep in touch with him every once in a while. I saw him when he was on Saturday Night Live here.
Yeah.
Not too long ago. And just a really cool guy. And it's really cool. He respects us as, you know, as artists and everything. So it's
awesome.
Much props out there to Ben Stiller.
Very cool. Awesome. We're going to take another break. How about the Backstreet Boys singing live? Is that going to do all right for everybody? I think so. Plus a trivia contest you'll never forget. More with the Backstreet Boys live on MTV next. Backstreet Boys live on MTV. Devoted fans outside, thousands and thousands and thousands. And a very, very nice group inside as well, providing the musical portion to today's program. Ladies and gentlemen, performing the Backstreet Boys, All I Have to Give.
Okay, babe, just tell me your problems. I'll try my best to kiss them all away.
Does he leave?
When do you need him the most? Does his friends get all your time?
Make some noise for the Backstreet Boys. That was awesome.
Thank you.
Awesome, awesome, awesome. What we're going to do now is I've been telling you about a little trivia contest we're going to have. Our producers have gone through each and every one of you guys in our studio audience and has found basically, there's 30 names in this fishbowl I have, you guys in this room. What I'm going to do is give this to you, Howie. We'll start with you. Each member of the band is going to pick a name. Now, when your name is called, you'll come forward and, you know, you'll be paired with one of the Backstreet Boys. You'll be a team in our trivia contest. Control yourself. So when you hear your name, please come down in an orderly fashion. Line up next to me. You guys will be paired. A little trivia. You'll have a nice gift. It'll be wonderful.
Here we go.
Howie, read your name first, sir.
Okay. I got Melissa Mitchell.
Melissa Mitchell. Where are you? Right here. Melissa?
Oh, right here. Oh, my goodness. Whoa. That was funny.
Melissa, are you here?
Pick me.
Oh, come on up. Come on up. Okay. Kev, you're next. Melissa's making her way here.
Christy Cortez.
Christy Cortez, right here. Right here in front. Bri?
Erica Hodges.
Erica Hodges. Come on down.
Erica Hodges.
Can you bring
you're
a Kentucky hat with you, please?
You're the next contestant on the Backstreet Boys Trivia.
I hope I say this right. Marissa D'Ambrosio. I think that's how
Melissa
you say it.
Melissa D'Ambrosio. Yep. She's in the very back, making her way up.
Marissa, that works. Come on down, girl.
Okay, Nick, the last one.
I don't know how to pronounce this. How do you pronounce this? Joanny Rosario.
There you go, right
yes,
in front.
Joanny
there they
Rosario.
Are, the five lucky winners. They will be paired with each of the Backstreet Boys. In fact, why don't you go ahead and just say hello to your teammate there. Come on over. Say hello
Where's
to your teammate.
Teammate at?
We're going to do a little trivia contest. Backstreet Boy and a Backstreet fan together making a team. They're meeting.
I'm getting hooked on phonics.
All right.
I guess I gotta
we're going to take a quick break. When we get back, we're going to see how our pairs do. Is everybody doing all right? How are you doing?
I'm fine.
Anybody going to faint? Everybody okay? You all right?
I guess.
Very excited. How are you doing? Are you about to cry or something?
I don't know.
Did you ever imagine this was going to happen?
No, never. I'm scared. I think I'm going to die on the spot.
All right, great. Well, there they are. They're the teams with the Backstreet Boys. We'll take a quick commercial break. When we get back, we'll pair them up. It's trivia time. MTV's Backstreet Boys Live continues in a moment. Come on back. You don't want to miss this. Square, MTV's backyard in Manhattan, New York. What a great shot there from the Broadway camera. So many people camped out last night, and there's our studio audience inside. Why? Two words. Backstreet Boys. Unbelievable how loud it is in here. Incredible. As we just showed you a minute ago, all those fans outside, I mean, there were literally people there. They've been here forever, and they're just such a, they're great, great fans. We actually, believe it or not, found the first person that came out to our Times Square studio to ask you guys a question. So watch this.
Hi, my name is Jeanette from Lyndhurst, Long Island, and I've been here since 12:30 a.m., and it was well worth the wait. Question for Nick. Nick, I heard you're a real big Nirvana fan. What is it about Nirvana that you like so much?
Well, we touched a little bit on that earlier, Nick, but you want to...
Well, first of all, they were unique. I think their music definitely, they were trendsetters. I think that they, you know, they definitely changed a lot of what music is nowadays. They set the grunge age, which was what they did back then. And I think that they're, like, especially, you know, Kurt Cobain, he was just a very, you know, unique person. His music was just, it was amazing. And I think that's one of the reasons that I like Nirvana, because they were just unique.
Very good. Okay. Well said, says Nick's partner. We're set up in trivia form now. We have the Backstreet Boys sitting next to them, the Backstreet fans. Let me explain the rules of what we're going to do here. Well, first, let me show you the grand prize for the Backstreet fan that should win is going to pick up this. I think we have a shot of it. It's, there it is on the screen. It's a platinum quadruple, and it's made out to the number one Backstreet Boys fan.
You know what? We don't even have one of those.
Yeah, the guys don't even have it. So that's what you're playing for, fans. We've teamed you guys up. Let me explain the rules. I'm going to ask a question. Some questions are actually for the Backstreet fans, and they're questions about the Backstreet Boys. I'll also go ask a question to the Backstreet Boys, and they're just about music in general. I will ask the question, and then when you hit your buzzer, if you know the right answer, I'll call on you. Then we'll get the right answer. If you do have the right answer, then let's see. They all have stickers there. Like, this is Brian's. Can you see that? That's right. Okay. And then the Backstreet Boy will put the sticker on. That symbolizes you have a correct point, and the winner gets that beautiful thing. Okay, let's get it. You guys get it? Got it? Good. Okay, this is to, I have to back up so you don't see it. To the Backstreet fans. To the fans. And please don't yell it out in the audience. Which Backstreet Boy says Michael Jackson is his favorite musician? All right. That was right over here.
AJ.
Wait, with the microphone, please. Okay, thanks.
AJ.
That's wrong.
All right. Who is it?
Me.
Okay, right here. In the microphone. Nick, help her out. You're right.
Yeah, he told her.
It's 1 point. Put a sticker on her. There you go. That's how it works.
Hey, Carson, you got to be gentle.
We're supposed to be gentle with the buzzers.
Good question. Brian just asked me, where are you supposed to put the stickers? All right, stop messing with the buzzers. Got to get creative, I guess. All right, this one goes to the Backstreet Boys. What miseducated Grammy Award-winning artist sometimes goes by the name El Boogie? To the Backstreet Boys.
No. I got it. I'm hitting
you were
it.
Hitting
hey,
it.
Hey, you got to answer.
Oh, it's the Backstreet Boys.
This is a question to Nick, I guess, because your partner hit your button for it.
No, too late. Don't answer the question.
What was the question?
I heard it. I know what the answer is.
Man, Nick,
what
you're
miseducated
cheating.
Grammy Award-winning artist sometimes goes by the name El Boogie?
I know it.
I don't know if
Lauren
Hill. AJ's dying it. Here.
I said Lauren Hill.
We got it.
We're going to give it to him.
I knew it.
Come on.
Gentlemen, we need to pay attention game.
You got another point there.
Works.
Yeah, your team gets points. All right.
Just checking. Sorry.
Okay, everybody's done now. Let's make sure these things are working. Great. These will go to the Backstreet fans. According to an informal poll, which Backstreet Boy keeps his room the messiest? All right here.
Nick?
That's wrong. Right here. That's wrong, too. Right over there.
Brian
is correct. That's a point for you. Now we can put a sticker of yourself right on that young lady.
You know what? Actually, that's AJ.
Yeah.
There you
go.
Actually,
it is
AJ.
Me. Just so you know.
That was the wrong. It's all good.
But we'll take it. We'll go.
All right.
It's all fair.
Backstreet Boys, this question's for you. What is the title of Nirvana's debut album? Nick?
That's not fair.
Debut album.
Never mind.
That's incorrect.
Oh, debut! Oh! I know it.
No.
I know it.
Don't yell it out if you know it.
Kev's next.
Kev's, you're lit up, but you don't know.
That was an inadvertent
buzzer. It's open
buzzer.
Now. All right, over there. Howie?
I'll just take a wild guess. Was it self-entitled Nirvana?
No.
No, you can't get a second chance.
I'm sorry, man.
I'm moving on.
The
answer was Bleach. This is to the Backstreet fans. To the Backstreet fans. Which Backstreet Boy lived in a log cabin for 8 years?
Kevin.
That's correct. There's the point. Brian, hook her up with a sticker.
All right.
That works. All right. This one's to the Backstreet Boys. Wait till your light goes off. Okay, now don't hit him. This one goes to the Backstreet Boys. Okay. Recently, Master P tried to break into what sport?
All
right. Right here.
The
Ryan.
NBA.
Basketball's the correct answer. That's right. Another sticker, another point.
That's just not quick enough.
We're not doing too good over
and
here.
And my buzzer doesn't like
Nick
me.
Nick and Brian's team, I think, is in the lead. How many stickers you got over there?
Our
Nick?
Buzzers are rigged.
Two.
They're rigged.
Two and two. Okay.
Here, start sticking these on. Nobody will know, I tell you.
Okay, here's to the Backstreet fans. What alternative lead singer is AJ in love with? Right over here.
I don't know that lead singer. Gwen Stefani?
That's correct. AJ?
Yes, that's correct.
Okay, good. Let's check. You got a sticker there and you're in the lead.
She thinks I'm psycho, I know.
To the Backstreet Boys. To the Backstreet Boys. What video was at the number one spot on TRL on Friday? Right?
Backstreet Boys.
That's right. You're still the one. It's a tie. What video was it?
Yeah, I was about to say that.
What video?
I want it Carson's way.
Yeah.
Rock the hit yourself for our national television.
Yeehaw. Okay, here we go. To the fans, Backstreet fans. Backstreet fans, name one of the movies that Howie starred in.
Parenthood.
Yeah! That's right, that's another sticker.
Yeah,
I think you're out
like
to a blistering lead with four. Nick, your team has three.
Have you guys
three.
Seen him in that? Have you rented it and watched
have
it?
Have you guys seen Howie?
Pretty funny.
He's really funny looking.
When I was like around 14 years old,
you're really funny
my hair
looking,
was like parted over the side. My mom made me wear it like that.
Okay, Backstreet Boys. This legendary old school rapper appeared on R.E.M.'s 91 album, Out of Time. Nick. It's a song from R.E.M.'s album, Out of Time, this old-school rapper.
I don't know.
Okay, the answer was KRS-One. Let's move on. To the Backstreet. To the Backstreet fans, name one of Kevin's secret nicknames. Right here.
Mr. Body Beautiful.
No. That's not what I have listed. Right over here. That's one of them.
Pumpkin?
That's right, that's right. Boo or Pumpkin? Those are the right answers. Very good. How many stickers do you have, Howie?
Two.
Two? Okay. Brian's still in the lead with four. Yeah, AJ, what's up with you? Come on now.
It doesn't work.
You got nothing.
Okay,
now don't hit him. Don't hit him. Don't hit him. This one goes to the Backstreet Boys. Madonna owns what record label? Right. Nick.
I do not. I know it.
Push a button and don't even know the answer.
Kevin.
Maverick.
Maverick is the correct answer. Like a Virgin Records. Of course, Prodigy's on.
Mine works when you don't ask a question, Carson. What's going on?
I don't know.
Mine works when you don't ask any questions.
Okay, here we go. To where are we? To the fans, the Backstreet fans. Which member of the group is a ventriloquist? Right here.
AJ.
Very nice. Brian's team has five correct points.
That's a big
AJ still stumped. Nick's in second place.
Yeah, man, bye.
Sorry.
Okay, damn. Here we go. Backstreet. What did we just do there, fans?
Boys.
Okay, boys. Backstreet Boys. What white wedding singer from the 80s appeared in the 98 movie The Wedding Singer? AJ.
Billy Idol.
That's correct. The buzzer works. Okay, put the sticker on. That's one for you, AJ. We've got to keep going so we can make this fair. To the fans, which two members of the band are cousins?
Oh, my God.
Right here. Kev, use the mic for
Brian and Kevin.
It's okay.
I'm terrible with
you. I'm forgetting myself.
You got stickers to worry about. Okay, this is the last question.
It's worth all the stickers.
Don't look at it, Brian.
It's worth all of them.
I'm trying to find a good one.
It's worth
I
want
to make it to the Backstreet Boys. Backstreet Boys, what is Marilyn Manson's real name? Right. Nick, do you know? Into the mic if you do.
He don't know.
Robert?
No.
I just saw it in the magazine.
I think it's, I'm not sure the actual last name. I think his first name is Brian. Or Steve.
That's right. They're going to be Brian.
Yep.
Woo-hoo! Is that all the time we have? I think that's it. How many do you have, Howie? How many you got?
Two.
Yeah, two. Kevin's team?
Two.
Two. How many you got?
Five.
How many you got, AJ?
12.
Two over there. It's Nick. We have a winner.
We have a winner.
Really good. Oh.
Our buzzer broke. It wasn't Ruiz Ray.
Sorry.
How do you feel?
Yeah, it was quick, though.
Here you go. It's yours.
I don't like my buzzer.
I don't know what to say. Thank you so much, MTV, and I love the Backstreet Boys. I don't know.
Very nice speech. You know what? You can step right down there and show it to your friends. Guys, come on up. That's all the time we have for today, but come on up here.
We want to thank the Backstreet Boys for stopping by. Howie and Kevin and Brian and AJ and Nick. Nick, come on up here. Come on up here, guys. Thank you. Thanks for spending the time with us. Howie?
I'm never going to
forget. Don't forget
this
Backstreet
day.
TV after TRL this Tuesday at 4:30. Don't forget Millennium.